Welcome to worship on this, the second Sunday of Advent. And as you might notice, it is also our Faith Formation Christmas program today. I have a couple announcements I want to point out before we get started here. And that in our prayers this week, we ask you to keep those members of the military who served during World War II. This week we remembered the Pearl Harbor attack. And let us keep in our prayers this week those from our community, both Salem and Lake Mills, in our prayers. And those names are Don Adams, Lawrence Branstead, Vern Hagen, Morris Lieberson, Wayne Miller, Doc Nelson, Wayne Roberts, Arlo Rogstead, Leo Schmidt-Huber, Jim Tweeten, and Don Wirt. We also ask that you keep in your prayers today Dan Hansen and Mary Proctor, who were married here yesterday evening. Dan Hansen is Gladys Hansen's son. Christmas program is now. And the other one I want to point out is the hospice tree lighting will be this week on Thursday in the Fellowship Hall at 6 p.m. And you are invited. It's a wonderful time to remember those who have gone before us. Any other announcements I need to remember? Okay. Then we are going to just have a little opening to light the Advent candles to remember that we are watching and waiting for the Lord. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, ruler of the universe. John the Baptist calls all people to prepare the Lord's way, for the kingdom of heaven is near. Bless us as we light the candles on this wreath. Baptize us with the fire of your Holy Spirit, that we may be a light shining in the darkness, welcoming others as Christ has welcomed us. For he is our light and our salvation. Blessed be God forever. Amen. And with that, it is time to begin our program.
Getting ready for Christmas. It's my favorite time of the year.
The stuff just fills up the house and gets in my way.
I'm so glad you were excited about it, but you have to remember that this stuff, as Chike put it, means something as well. Why do we celebrate Christmas?
It's Jesus' birthday.
It's when we remember that Jesus came into the world as a baby.
That's right.
Why do we have to decorate then?
Well, let's talk about some of this stuff and what it all means. Let's start with the evergreen tree that we decorate each year.
An evergreen tree has a very appropriate name. Is evergreen always green? It has not become dormant in the winter, as other trees do. The color green represents new life, and the needles of the evergreen always point heavenward. It symbolizes our everlasting life with Jesus Christ.
We should be always the evergreen tree, always full of life, never becoming dormant in our life with Christ. Our arms are lifted heavenward. The bread of God is the one who comes down from heaven. He gives life to the world. John 6:33.
I didn't realize.
Oh, Christmas tree, how true you sing.
didn't realize.
Wow, I didn't either.
I just thought it was a tree.
Yeah, I didn't know that it meant something.
What does this other stuff mean?
How about the ornaments?
Ornaments are used to decorate Christmas trees each and every year. People look for the perfect ones to fit on their tree. Our Christmas tree just won't seem complete without our ornaments. Ornaments can symbolize the blessings in our lives. Our lives just won't be complete without God's blessings. Everything that we have is due to God loving us so much that He wants to shower us with His blessings.
Just as ornaments are all different shapes and sizes, blessings are all different as well. God picks and chooses each blessing for us so that it will be just right. The next time you decorate your tree and as you put up each ornament, think of a blessing that God has given you. I think you'll find that you'll run out of ornaments before you can run out of blessings. Every man shall give as able, according to the blessing of the Lord your God that He has given you. Deuteronomy 16:17.
Blessings.
We have so many blessings.
We have our home and our family.
Oh, there's so much more. How about we talk about the lights and candles?
Lights and candles are used to give light. When a room is full of darkness, it is dark. But if you light a single match in a dark room, the room is light. There may be more darkness, but the light overpowers it. We are that light. There can be a single light in the world of darkness. We must share our light with the world so that the light increases. You are the light in the world. A city set on a hill cannot be hidden, nor do people light a lamp and put it under a basket, but on a stand, and it gives a light to all in the house. Matthew 5:14-15.
Thank you. I love the lights.
They're so pretty.
I guess I never looked at it the way the lights for God.
Exactly. We can also decorate with bells.
The bell rings out to the guide to lost. The bell rings out to guide the lost sheep back to the fold, signifying that all are precious in the eyes of the Lord. Jesus is our shepherd, and he laid down his life for us so that we may spend eternity with him in heaven. He is calling us forward to follow him through his word. Are you going to listen? If a man has 100 sheep and one of them has gone astray, does he not leave in the 99 on the mountains and go search for that one that went astray? Matthew 18:12. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. John 10:11.
The bells sound so beautiful.
I just love listening to them.
Who likes candy canes?
Me!
The candy cane symbolizes multiple things. If you hold it upright, it looks like a shepherd's crook. The shepherds were some of the few people who were able to see the baby Jesus in Bethlehem. If you turn the candy cane upside down, it looks like a J. Jesus starts with the letter J. The colors of the candy cane are also symbolic. The red represents the blood that Jesus shed for us on the cross, and the white represents the purity of Jesus.
There are candy canes with three small red stripes running around it. These stripes symbolize the Trinity, God the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Who knew that this delicious, simple candy was so proudly symbolic of our Lord Jesus Christ in his simple birth? And she will bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. Matthew 1:21.
These are so delicious.
I love this part of Christmas.
It means so many things.
There seems to be a reason why we do everything that we do.
I can see now how this stuff has meaning.
I'm so glad that you are changing your mind about some of these things. Do you know what the star represents?
star is a heavenly sign of prophecy fulfilled ages ago, the shining hope for all mankind. The star led the wise men to find the baby Jesus. These wise men traveled many miles following the star in the sky. The star was their guiding light to the Savior. God was the wise men's travel agent and source leading them to the greatest destination known to man, the Savior. We now have his word as our guiding light to lead us to be with him in heaven. Are you going to have him and beyond the star which they have seen in the east, west, went before them till it came and stood over where the young child was. Then he saw the star, then he rejoiced with exceeding great joy.
The star to Jesus.
It must have been an amazing journey.
I'm glad that we have the Bible now to help lead us.
Yes, God's word leads us to Jesus.
We like to put the angel on top of our tree.
Imagine you are a lonely shepherd watching over your sheep. This night seems no different than any other. Then all of a sudden, an angel of the Lord is in the sky above you, telling you of the Savior's birth. You, a shepherd, why did God send an angel to tell shepherds? Because the message that God had about the birth of Jesus was for all people, not just for the right, not just for the Jew, everyone.
God chose his number one messenger to tell the lowest of people in the world's eye of his son's birth. God looks at the heart, not what the world looks at, thank goodness. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and to the glory of the Lord shone around about them. And they were so afraid, and the angel said unto them, fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people, for unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. Luke 2:9-11.
messenger of God.
The angel told the good news of Jesus' birth.
Wow, I didn't know, but what about all this other stuff we put around the house?
Well, Chike, let's talk about this holly that we're going to put on the table.
We see holly as decorations during the Christmas season, but do we really understand what holly stands for? The leaves represent the crowns of thorns that were placed upon Jesus' head as he was being crucified. The berries symbolize the blood that he shed for us. He endured criticism, excruciating pain, and embarrassment. All that for you and I.
The next time you see a decoration with holly on it, remember what was done for you so he could spend eternity with you. I know I will. And twisting together a crown of thorns, they put it on his head and put a reed in his right hand. And kneeling before him, they mocked him, saying, "Hail, King of the Jews." Matthew 27:29.
Thank you. amazing what he did for us.
It makes me feel blessed to know him. He went through all that for me.
He came to this earth in order to die for me and you.
That's quite an amazing thing to think about during this Christmas season.
That leads us to this wreath that will hang on the door.
The wreath had its evergreen branches bent in a circle so that the ends touched, having no beginning or end. Just as there is no beginning or end of Jesus' eternal love for us. Just as the wreath looks the same throughout and seems to not change, so he will always be the same. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. Hebrews 13:8.
That's a great reminder that even though we change and grow, he'll always be right there. Now what about the presents? Those can't have a meaning.
Well, you'll be surprised then.
These days, the world has forgotten the reason of Christmas. Most people seem to think that getting presents is the greatest thing about Christmas. Other people seem to think that presents have nothing to do with Christmas. Well, they are both wrong. The wise men came to visit Jesus as a young child and gave him presents. They have his gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
They offered him gold as a king and paying him tribute, frankincense as a god, for they honored God with the smoke of incense. And myrrh, as a man that should die, myrrh was used in embalming dead bodies. These wise men saw this child and knew that he was a king, God, and he would die for the sins of the world. How can anyone know, with the knowledge that we have now, not believe? The wise men went to the house. There they saw the child with his mother Mary. They bowed down and worshipped him. They opened their treasures. They gave him gold, incense, and myrrh. Matthew 2:11.
Thank you.
presents.
But I didn't know there was a reason we give gifts.
But Jesus is really the greatest gift to all of us.
He truly is.
I never knew that the wise men's gifts had meaning. What about the wrapping? That's just something that we made up, right?
Yes and no. The bows and ribbons do have a special meaning that would be good for us to remember.
Many people spend hours wrapping all of their presents during Christmas time. They use ribbons, garlands, and bows to make sure that their presents are beautiful and possible. What they don't realize is that items that they use to complete the outside of the gift is more meaningful than the actual gift inside.
The bow ties our presents with a beautiful ribbon, just as Jesus ties us as Christians together in his love. We may not be in the same family, but we are all in the family of God. Jesus is the ribbon that bends us together, and all this put on love, which binds everything together in a perfect harmony.
Thank you.
just thought the wrappings were to hide the present inside.
Yeah, I never knew they had their own meaning.
There's really a lot to think about.
I guess I'll have to look at things differently.
That's for sure. I never knew that all this stuff had meaning.
People do get a little crazy with the stuff of Christmas, the parties, the gift giving, the busyness of the Christmas season. What we need to do is slow down and enjoy every moment by remembering the true meaning of Christmas. Who wants a cookie?
I know there's not a meaning in the cookie.
Oh, you'd be surprised.
Making cookies is my favorite pastime for most families. During the Christmas season, cookie cutters are used to turn ordinary dough into edible masterpieces. God doesn't use cookie cutters when He creates each one of us. He makes every one of us so special and unique that He would have to break the mold after just one use.
He is the potter and we are his clay. He wants to mold us into his masterpieces. We only need to be moldable and willing to follow his lead. Behold, like the clay in the potter's hand, so are you in my hand, O the house of Israel. Jeremiah 18:6. Please come join us downstairs after the program for cookies.
Go eat cookies.